try to recall the plot of Final Fantasy VII Advent Children.
Fuck this movie.
Man, remember when we were in college and everyone was hype about Advent Children and we found a pirated version of this thing on the student drive and we saw it early and we thought it was the greatest thing ever? It has not aged well.
This movie ruined Final Fantasy VII for over a decade.
Well, it's a good thing that we're gonna get a new one soon. Or rather, remake, my bad. All right, let's just get this out of the way, yeah?
Let's go through this garbage.
It's not that bad, but it was made by people who've never made movies before. Real quote. Anyways, Advent Children takes place several years after the meteor incident. Shinra is still around, but they're mostly, like, dismantled. All of Midgar is slums because of the wreckage of the meteor and whatever.
Yeah.
Right? And there's this SARS epidemic going around.
Oh, God.
And nobody knows how to cure it. And they're trying to fight it, but the SARS is caused by Mako. I think Midgar is quarantined. They've kept all the SARS-infected people in Midgar so they don't infect Calm or anything.
Okay.
Most of the movie takes place in Midgar. Except
yes.
For the very opening scene where Cloud is on his way to, I guess, visit Tifa or something. Because Tifa's helping the SARS victims. And along the way, he visits Zack's gravesite, I think. Because he presses F to pay respects. And then he hops on his cool motorcycle that made billions of toys of. And he gets attacked by the three antagonists of this movie. Their names are Kadaj, Loss, and Yahoo. Three silver-haired men in black who work for Organization 13 or something. And they're constantly crying because they want to see their mommy. And Cloud knows where the mommy is. It's Genova. It's fucking Genova.
It's fucking Genova.
So, they have a cool motorcycle fight where Cloud gets shot in the face, but it's fine. And this motorcycle scene amounts to basically nothing. I mean, I think he blows up one of their motorcycles and they're all like, oh man, oh no, I'm gonna go cry to mommy about it. If only I knew where she was. So Cloud makes it to the city and he, like, I think he, for some reason, gets intercepted by either Reno or Rude or both of them. And they're all like, hey man, before you go visit that girl, I don't know what Cloud and Tifa's relationship status is at this point, because it's very ambiguous. But they're like, hey, before you go visit your kind of girlfriend, I need you to go meet with my boss. And you see fucking Rufus, he's in a wheelchair and he has this fucking towel on his face, because he's been affected by SARS. And you're like, oh, hey, Rufus, should I feel bad for you? It was kind of your fault that Midgar's like this. And he's like, aha, get your licks in now. Hey, have you heard about those three fucking Organization 13 bastards? And like, yeah, I just fought them. They shot me in the fucking face. Rufus is all like, okay, I'm gonna say some cryptic shit and wheel away. And you know what? A lot of this fucking movie is just Cloud, Tifa hanging out and not really doing much. I think while Cloud is off visiting Rufus, fucking Loss decides to show up at the church where Tifa is. Because, sure, Tifa knows where Mother is.
Oh, God.
And they're all like, hey, do you know where my mommy is? And Tifa doesn't say anything, she just assumes a fighting stance. And they have a punch fight in the church. And that's where the really cool shot of Tifa landing on the church relief is. So then, you think, oh yeah, Tifa's gonna kick ass because, you know, Cloud kicked ass. But no, dude uses the stun gun that's on his fucking arm, and Tifa goes out like a bitch.
I hate this movie.
I know. And I think, fucking Yahoo shows up. He's like, hey, Loss, look over there. It's a big chest of materia. Let's steal it. Maybe mommy is in the chest of materia.
Oh, God.
So they take the materia. And Cloud finally gets to meet up with Tifa, and they say the one line that pretty much sums up the entire movie. Cloud's all like, I don't know what to do. The SARS outbreak is becoming a huge problem, and I can't solve it. Eris was the only one who could solve it, and she's dead. Wah, I'm so sad. And Tifa's all like, dilly dally shilly shally. Dilly dally shilly shally.
Fuck this movie.
Cloud, you're dilly dallying, shilly shallying around. You need to move forward and not dilly dally so much. And Cloud's all like, Tifa, that's the dumbest thing I have ever heard you fucking say. And then we transition to, I don't know, like this big gathering outside of some fucking plaza.
Well, if you remember, the boys took more than just the materia.
Oh yeah, they stole Marlene, I think, who also has SARS.
Mm-hmm. Marlene and?
Some kid. I don't fucking know.
There was a kid.
I don't know his name. I don't fucking remember his name.
But also all the children.
Alright, fine. They stole all the kids!
The Advent children.
Really?
I don't know.
That can't be why it's called Advent children. In any case, they take all the kids, and they bring them to fucking, the center plaza, and they're all like, hey, Cloud, if you don't bring out Mommy... We're gonna start killing the children. And you know who arrives on scene? The heroes, the Turks show up.
Yeah.
And Reno and Rude are like, fuck you. Midgar is our turf. Get the fuck out. But these guys are completely outclassed by these fucking Organization 13 assholes. So Reno and Rude are fighting Lost and Yahoo, but the Turks are completely outmatched. But they put up a good fight until Cloud gets there. And then by the time Cloud gets there, the main dude, Kadaj, is all like, where's Mommy? Tell me where Mommy is, goddammit. And then Cloud's all like, I don't have your mom, but I think I know who does. And I guess Rufus shows up. He's all like, I have Mother. If you want Mother, you gotta chase me. I'm over here in the derelict Shinra Tower. So, I guess fucking Kadaj hops on a motorcycle and Cloud has to chase him.
Oh,
so we can have another motorcycle fight. And I guess they summon monsters or something because monsters attack the children. And Tifa shows up and the whole crew shows up.
Yeah, they have this big scene.
Yeah, there's this big scene where everybody shows up.
Everyone is here.
Fucking Tifa shows up. Yuffie shows up. Cid shows up, Red 13 with Kate Sith shows up, Barrett shows up, Vincent shows up, everybody is here!
Yeah!
While Cloud is racing towards Shinra Tower. Wait, and then at this point they summon Bahamut, and Cloud has to slice Bahamut in half. Then they have to go chase fucking, Kadaj. God, I'm getting everything wrong.
It's fine, this
everything
movie
leads,
was a mistake.
Everything leads up to, the Turks blowing up a bridge, because they're fucking awesome. But they get to Shinra Tower, and, like, I don't know what happens to Lawson and Yahoo. I think they're dead at this point. Because the only thing that matters is that Kadaj gets to Rufus. And Rufus stands up and goes, I'm not disabled after all! You want Mommy? Her fucking head is in this tiny box! Go get her! And he, like, tosses the thing off the tower, and fucking Kadaj jumps after the box, and Rufus is like, no, no, you don't, bitch. I'm just gonna be a cool guy and jump off the tower myself and pull out my shotgun and shoot you on the way down. Cloud arrives at the tower at the same time that Kadaj picks the box or grabs the box, and then he eats the box. And there's this big explosion, and Rufus is fine somehow. And after Kadaj eats the box, he turns into Surf Evils! Dun, 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 dun. Because Kadaj absorbed all of the SARS into himself.
Oh my god.
And the SARS were actually Genova. And as you know, Genova loves wearing the Sephiroth rubber mask skin over her body. And so we can have one cool fight scene, and so she can taunt Cloud one last fucking time. Cloud beats her with the epic Omni-slash type, whatever it's called. Eh, who cares?
Who cares?
So then, yeah, Cloud defeats Sephiroth, and then Sephiroth turns back into Kadaj, and fucking SARS is cured! So Cloud saves the day, and he dilly-dallies no longer, and he rides off into the sunset, and fuck this movie. It sucks. And that's the plot of Advent Children.